Hi guys, so the class update is out and it kind of is great. Like, it's kind of great, but there's still more to work on, more to be desired. So mages got a bit shafted, but they are still the best class in the game. People might think otherwise, but it does open up more class diversity overall. What do I mean by that? Well, if you see here in the mystery tab, Word of Elements don't give more damage. Every other class's special skill gives more damage. But it's quite fair because mages has been getting bonus damage every single update. Like it was not fair to begin with. So would I really call it a loser? In terms of Pyromancer, I think that it fixed a lot of PvP issues. The mystery passive, because Word of Elements now recovers MP. And so there should not be any more MP issues, but I can't confirm that because I have not PvP'd after the mystery update came out. And I would not say it's that much of a loser either because Firebird, the three birds, get more damage. They put Blink here, but you don't really use Blink for damage. So yeah. Personally, a lot of people don't like this Electro Blades Array skill. Personally, I think it's an okay skill. I would not use it outside of auto mode. I only use it when I'm autoing. That's what it's good for. Because every time it hits an enemy, it gives you HP. And it hits like three times. So yeah. It basically lets you auto better. Because Blink never worked in auto. So they also gave you 5% damage done and 5% magical damage done. This gave like I think like 2K coefficient. Pretty good. It also gives the rest of your skills extra damage if you get the books for it. And then level 3 and above will give you an increased damage effect. The mystery passives really make things more fair for other classes. But yeah, I prefer the auto for with this skill set. Because many times you will be playing on auto, because why click buttons, you know? If you're gonna ask me, do I think this skill is good? Fuck no, I don't think it's good. It's bad. It gives you more transform bursts, but you know, it's just 3 seconds of crit damage. Some people think you use it over Advanced Firestorm, but no, you do not use it over Advanced Firestorm. You use it over Blink. So yeah, but there's also another skill coming. And I don't think it's gonna be good because it sounds like it's gonna make you be stuck in the skill, which is never a good thing. It looks like a fairy arrows. It looks like it's gonna sound like fairy arrows. Which is terrible. And I don't think you even have enough skill points for all of this stuff. Okay. So yeah. Also, this is really desirable. Awakening attribute bonus. 3.15%. I think it gets higher with every skill points you use, but I'm not quite sure. Let me check in my stat sheet. So how high is my coercion right now? I don't feel like my coercion increased, but I'm not sure. Like, I'm not sure. But I'll check the next time I see an increase from that, because that is really weird. I should have gained like 300 coercion if that thing actually worked. So I think this might not be working right now, but I'm not sure. Yeah, that's weird. Let's see. So these are the winners and losers for the patch. This is Pyromancer, and I believe that Pyromancer, they won in the AFK department, but they did not win anything substantial, so there's that. Now I shall be talking about probably Twin Star next would be the easiest because my ult is Twin Star. But I really don't know what they want, but I do feel like Twin Star is a winner, like it's an absolute win to get more healing. So off to the next one.